Do you want to talk about Midnight Mass a little?
Yes,
oh,
I do.
I love that show.
You like it? We all finished.
Yeah, I finally watched the show.
Midnight Mass was fucking fantastic. The guy who plays the priest is just every scene he's in, the other actors have to be upset because he dominates the scene. Like he makes everybody else's actor, you know, talents diminish every time.
I just realized that I'm talking about Midnight Gospel, the cartoon. Which
God damn you. All right. Well, look, for those of you who don't listen to PKN, first of all, shame on you. First of all,
talking about Midnight Ride of the Western. I thought I was finally.
No, I was talking about Midnight Cowboy, the 70s movie.
Yeah. When he dies of AIDS. Yeah. I thought that's why you wanted to talk about it.
Yeah. It makes sense. You know,
no, Midnight Mass, it's a Netflix show and it's very, very good. It's a bit of a vampire tale. It's a bit of that, but it's very, very good. You look it up online, and that's the first thing in the fucking review.
My recommendation is this for this show: go in blind because it is a mystery.
I was until now.
I know, right? Jesus Christ! if you go in blind, you won't know what the fuck's going on. We're gonna put Dumbledore's a spoiler tag powerful. In now. You've ruined it. You've ruined it for so many thousands, tens of thousands, and they put you in the jizz.
Hundreds of thousands,
and they put you in the jizz biz.
I give it fucking two thumbs up, and I really enjoyed it. I watched it in one sitting, 7 hours worth. I will say this: if you're not convinced by us, like RLM did a review, Red Letter Media, they really enjoyed it as well. I watched 2 minutes of their review and then immediately went to Netflix and watched 7 hours of this show. Like whenever they tell me to watch something, I do. There was a horror movie a while back, like the Black Coat's Daughter or something like that. They were also right about that was really good. But in any case, this is a really fucking good TV show. There is a lot of talking. There is a lot of character development. There is a little CGI that works out really well. They use it sparingly. They it takes you a while to figure out what's going on. I want to say about 15 minutes into episode two, I had figured out most of the story and I knew exactly what was going on by like episode four. I was like, oh no,
I'm mostly done episode two and I don't know shit. It's apparently a TV show about dead cats.
Nope, there's a lot more than that. I was like,
more than that.
I was super like when Kyle he recommended it to
I'm
us.
Mostly joking.
I know. When he was like,
there are dead cats.
I was like, in our private text, Kyle, because you were like, if anybody thinks they know what's going on, just text me privately, and I sent stuff to you, and you figured it out so fucking quickly that I was like, I felt like a challenge was issued where I'm like, all right. Episode three, I need to have this figured out. And I thought I had it mostly figured out by episode three. And I texted Kyle my predictions and he was like, spot on, my friend, spot on. And I was like, he would never say that if it was correct. So obviously I missed something here. And I did miss a couple things, but it's really, really a good show. Midnight Mass. I like it a lot. I don't know what the actor's name is who plays the priest.
Don't either.
He doesn't look familiar to me with his face and anything, but he's tremendous. I hope he gets more work because
I do too.
Are we supposed to hate the chick that criticizes the priest?
Yes. Or wait. Which one?
Well, then I'm on the right track.
The white lady who's very churchy.
I don't think there's any black people in this show.
No, there are. There are. Maybe you haven't watched far enough. But maybe. Well,
she's very churchy. She criticized his choice of gold outfit.
Oh, that wasn't she wasn't criticizing. She was like curious, like, and see, that's a clue in itself. See, I caught that clue. That's one I caught. Oh, did you catch it too?
I did, but only because I have Catholic family, so I know.
Yeah, so like you wear different colors on different days, just like.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not a Catholic, but they lay it out there, like I want to say you wear the gold one on like feast day, and the green one was the one that was more appropriate for
that's
whatever
ordinary
day it was.
Time.
Yeah, for ordinary. So. I found that very interesting and that I read a lot into him wearing that because he didn't seem like the type of man, but I knew two things at that point. Anyway, I knew who the priest was and I knew that he's not the type of man to not know what fucking color shirt to wear. And so those two things added together led me to like go down that rabbit hole that got me to like solving the whole mystery of the show in like two episodes. It's a good fucking show. It's not a fucking challenge. It's TV meant to be enjoyed, but I highly recommend it. There's a mystery going on. There's some neat characters. It reminds me so much of something that Stephen King wrote. I had to do a double check. I was like, Stephen King wrote this, right? They did Stephen King better than Stephen King does Stephen King. Like, you even have like the inciting incident with a Volkswagen involved right there at the beginning, and the character haunted by the flashbacks with a little bit of ghost stuff going on. And it's like, man, this is Stephen King beat for beat, but it's not. And then you also have like the core concept of the show that I won't spoil too much. That's another Stephen King. He loves that shit. He loves that specific subject matter. All the stuff about loss and regret, family, groupthink, the way that religion can twist people's minds, perception-based information, you know, the way that, like, think about how those first cavemen were down here. They've got their fire at night. Other caveman has his fire at night, and they look in the sky and they say, wow, who builds their campfires up there? Who are those people? And you know, that sort of mindset, like they had this, okay, lights are campfires. There are lights. Lights must be campfires.
Yeah.
Well, they put things together that way because it was what they knew. They had this framework, and they plugged in outside information into the framework they understood, and they end up with a flawed understanding of reality. And you see that concept repeated later on. And it's a really, really smart, well-written, well-directed, all the way around, enjoyed it kind of show. Yeah,
well-acted. Like, there were so many characters. Like, Woody, you said there weren't any black characters. The black girl in the wheelchair, she's a very big
character. She's a havesy.
And I like her a lot. She's a very good actress. I like her. But the priest stole the fucking show. He stole the show in most episodes.
Well, Midnight Gospel is pretty good. It's
what's that about?
It's about a podcast that gets animated. I don't know if you guys know anything about that.
No.
But it's a good show. Yeah,
it's
a good
show. It's really not our subject matter expertise.
It is about that, but it's really good. You should check it out.
I got a couple of those. I got a couple of those animated stories. We should do something with them.
We should upload them or something. Yeah.
I don't know what to do with them. I don't know what. Maybe we just watch them on the show. I don't
raise some money for it.
Yeah. Let's sell them.
Yeah.
No. Let's not do that.
Oh, no.